Welcome back everyone to another video. Now in this one we're taking a look at a very small script that will give you a very basic BusyBox based Linux operating system around 100 megabytes in size total. And so this script was done by Michael, and here is his GitHub page. Again, the GitHub page for Build Linux would be in the description down below. So let's go ahead and take a look at how to create a very small Linux based operating system using this very script. So we have taken a look at build root in one of my previous videos, and the fact is that it is just too complicated for someone who really needs a no nonsense .img or a .iso file that boots straight up without doing anything, and just a simple script that will make that happen. So this script has three main parts. So the first part is the Linux kernel, of course, and we'll take a look at the make file. So the first part is the Linux kernel. So the Linux kernel, you can set the version right here, but if you actually are going to set the version, you might need to add a few options of your own later on, and I think leaving it at 4.4 is also like a good LTS kernel. Leaving it at 4.4 is no big deal. And the second one is BusyBox. So Linux kernel is your kernel LAN, and BusyBox makes up the whole of your user LAN with all the tools that you need to boot a Linux based operating system. So BusyBox version, again you can change that as well. Both of them are downloaded and compiled. And then the third part is your grub. So grub is installed directly from your current operating system using this script of genimage.sh, which is also called inside the make file, and here we have the grub install command. And so let's go ahead, and before cloning it we do need to deal with some dependencies. So again, I'm doing this from Ubuntu 16. You will need to find the packages that are required for your operating system. Fedora and Arch Linux will have different packages. I have tested it on Fedora and Michael has tested it on Arch Linux, so it actually works pretty well on both those systems. So a simple sudo apt install, the first one being build essential, and this is required for building your Linux kernel. Then we have musl tools. Now musl tools is musl is a libc or glibc replacement, so it is a replacement for the C library already present in your operating system. Musl is basically faster and lightweight and produces smaller binaries as far as I know, and that's always a good thing. So it is not using glibc, it is actually using musl, and we'll go ahead. And then the last one is an interesting one. So this is grub pc bin. So if you are running a BIOS based system or a legacy boot system, you won't need this dependency because it would be already installed. But on a system where the default boot is EFI or UEFI, you would need this because this is an install, and the grub installer requires these grub PC binaries to create the image in order to boot the image on a legacy boot disk on a legacy BIOS, and that's why we need this particular dependency. So let's go ahead, press enter. Now I have all of them already installed, so that shouldn't be an issue apart from my spellings. Again, I have all of them installed, so that's not a big deal. So let's go ahead and clone the repository. So git clone, and cloning into build Linux shouldn't take too long. It's a very small script. Now cd into build Linux, and here there is a submodule that we need to initialize in the kernel headers. So git submodule init and get submodule update, and this should initialize the kernel headers. Now the reason why we need kernel headers separately, because these are specific to the MUSL library rather than using glibc, so that's why these headers are separately needed, although we are downloading the kernel headers as well. So again, the script runs very simply. What you need to do is make command, so make, and then j followed by the number of cores you have, optional, and then image for a .img file that will run with it. So this should take around 5 minutes, I'm guessing 5 to 10 minutes, also depends on your download speed, but there is not much to download, and as you can see, BusyBox has already started downloading, and so has the Linux kernel, and we have the BusyBox already compiling. And with that said, I'll put it in sort of a time lapse and get back to you once it's done. Alright, so it is done, and here is the file. So if you navigate to our build Linux folder, and here is the image file at around 104 megabytes. So that's about it. So let's go ahead and boot it up, and since this is very light, we don't really need much to boot it up. So qemu and system and x86 64 and then hdaimage, and this should boot the OS. There we are. So login as root, press enter, and then now you can see I'm not really able to type, and that is for some reason on this particular boot, this particular qemu, it worked fine on my Fedora machine, but on this one the keyboard layout has changed. So una is q, na, and then m is something, m and e, space dash is, and then a, and there we have Linux hostname 4.4.52 x86-64, and then the Linux build. So maybe something more, cat, and so it is very difficult for me to type at the moment, and oh yes, so this works. And there we have it, our CPU info. So thank you so much for watching, and this was it, a very small, a very simple script to create a very basic Linux based operating system using BusyBox, and the script's name is build Linux. The links will be down in the description. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one.